Our topic for today is transfer pricing. Okay, so most students find this topic very confusing. Pero after this video, easy na yan. Okay, kung bahala sa inyo. Okay, transfer pricing is under the topic of responsibility accounting. Okay, sir, what is transfer price? Okay. Transfer price is the price charged by one department to another department. Okay? Transfer price can be at market price. It can be at variable cost. Can be at production cost or full cost or negotiated price. Okay, so yung issue here is how much should be the transfer price. Okay, so this is the rule. Remember this, the rule is the transfer price should be set at a price that maximizes the profit of the company as a whole. Okay, maximizes the profit of the company as a whole. Actually, call it goal congruence. Okay? I'll give you an illustration para hindi kayo malito. Imagine this is the company. Okay? Ayan. Company. And then, this is Department A. Ayan. This is Department B. Okay? So, let's say si Department A manufactures ink. Okay? While Department B manufactures a pen, for example, ball pen. Okay, pen. And let's say meron ditong customer. Okay, customer. And here is the supplier. Alright? So, si A, pwede siyang magbenta outside, right? To the customer. Okay? And since yung ink, kailangan siya to manufacture a pen, pwede rin magbenta si A to Department B. Tama ba? While si Department B naman, pwede siyang bumili from the supplier, okay? Or pwedeng bumili siya from Department A. Got it? Okay. Now, yung transfer price is the price from Department A to B. Okay? Yun yung transfer price. Again, yung goal is dapat ma-maximize yung profit of the whole company. Okay? Hindi lang profit ni Department A or profit ni Department B. Profit of the whole company. We call it goal congruence. Okay? So, here is the general rule for transfer pricing. Ito lang natatandaan nyo sa transfer pricing. Okay? The general rule is this. Okay? Ito yung maximum transfer price. Maximum TP. Ayan, transfer price. Minimum transfer price. Okay, maximum and minimum transfer price. Okay, doon muna tayo sa maximum transfer price. Sir, what is the maximum transfer price? So, isipin nyo ganito siya. How much yung maximum na pwedeng i-charge ni A to B? Okay, the maximum transfer price is the price kung magkano bibili ni B yung ink if bibili si B from outside supplier. Kasi if mas mahal yung price ni A to B compared to the supplier, well, ang gagawin lang ni B, bibili siya from outside supplier. Does that make sense? It means the maximum transfer price is the selling price or the market price. Got it? Oh, tama lang, di ba? Sir, ano naman yung minimum transfer price? Okay, what is the minimum transfer price? Tatandaan nyo dyan. Minimum transfer price, it depends if there's an excess capacity, with excess capacity. Okay? Or if it's without excess capacity. Okay? The rule for the minimum transfer price is this is equal to the incremental cost plus the opportunity cost of the selling division. Okay? So the minimum transfer price is the incremental cost plus the opportunity cost of the selling division. Sino ba yung selling division here? it's Division A or Department A, okay? So it depends. If there's an excess capacity, so ano ibig sabihin ng excess capacity? So let's say si Department A, let's say yung total capacity niya is 10,000 units, okay? And then yung outside sales of Department A is 8,000 units. So we call this with excess capacity because may 2,000 pa siya na pwedeng ibenta to B. Kuha niyan? Okay, if there is an excess capacity, the general rule is the incremental cost is equal to the viable cost. Okay? Because yung incremental cost to manufacture another unit is equal to the viable cost. Yung fixed cost, hindi siya incremental cost in this case because i-incur mo pa rin yung fixed cost whether magbenta siya si A to B or not. Okay? So, the incremental cost is the viable cost. Sir, what if there is no excess capacity? Let's say total capacity of A is 10,000 units and yung binibenta niya to outside customers, 10,000 units din. So, we call it without excess capacity. So, the general rule is incremental cost, which is variable cost, plus the opportunity cost. Opportunity cost here is equal to the lost contribution margin. Got it? Dun sa kanina, yung with excess capacity, wala kang opportunity cost, right? Because ang binibenta mo lang to outsiders is 8,000. So, wala kang opportunity cost for the 2,000. That's why here, variable cost lang. Opportunity cost is zero. While if there's an excess capacity, pag nagbenta ka to B, hindi ka na makakabenta to outside, right? So that's why it's variable cost plus the opportunity cost is the contribution margin. Uy! Sir, di ba yung variable cost plus contribution margin, di ba equal siya to the selling price? Because from our last video, we discussed that selling price minus variable cost is equal to contribution margin. So, variable cost plus contribution margin is equal to the selling price. So, ulitin natin ha. The maximum transfer price is the selling price. The minimum transfer price, it depends. If there is an excess capacity, variable cost. If no excess capacity, variable cost plus loss contribution margin, which is also equal to the selling price. Okay, let's go to our theory questions. Ayan, okay, so theory questions muna. Alright. So, the number one, a transfer price is, letter A, an accounting device to turn profit centers into investment centers. Letter B, price charged by one segment of the company for goods or services provided to another segment. So, yun yan. So, price charged by one segment to another segment. That's letter B. Only useful in segment that deals with outsiders as well as with other segments of the same company. The amount charged by a cost center for a service performed for a profit center. So, the cost center, profit center, investment centers, you call these responsibility centers. We have a separate video for responsibility centers, okay? But we know the transfer price is letter B. Okay, letter B. Transfer prices, reduce employee turnover, are necessary for investment centers, should encourage the kinds of behavior that upper level management wants, are not used for department with high amounts of fixed costs. Actually, the answer here is letter C. You call this goal congruence. Okay, letter C. So, yung kanina, yung general rule natin here, that's why this is the general rule. Pag ito yung sinunod mo, ang magiging end result is yung profit of the company as a whole will be maximized. Okay? Hindi lang yung profit ni A or ni B, but yung whole company. You call it goal congruence. Alright, let's go to number 3. The criteria used for evaluating performance. Letter A, should be designed to help achieve goal congruence. That's correct, okay? It's letter A. It can be used only with profit centers, investment centers. Should be used to compare past performance, current performance, motivate people to work in the company's best interest. Oh, by the end, but the best answer here is letter A. Should be designed to help achieve goal congruence. With two autonomous division managers, the price of goods transferred between the divisions needs to be approved by corporate management, both divisional managers and corporate management is the manager of the buying division. Answer here is letter B, okay? Both divisional managers, both the buying and selling division or department, Okay, letter B. Alright. Number 5, the minimum transfer price is determined by... Okay, so let's go back to our lesson earlier. Minimum transfer price, again, it's the incremental cost plus the opportunity cost of the selling division. Okay. The minimum transfer price is determined by letter A, incremental cost in the selling division. Okay, yun yung answer natin, letter A. Letter B, the lowest outside price for the good. Yun yung maximum transfer price. Am I right? Yung maximum transfer price. Because the maximum transfer price is the selling price outside or the market price. The extent of idle capacity, negotiations between buying and selling division. The minimum transfer price, we know it's the incremental cost in the selling division. And usually, the incremental cost is equal to the variable cost. Okay? Yung fixed cost in the, because even if mag-manufacture ka ng additional unit, for the other department, you will still incur that fixed cost. That's why incremental cost is usually the variable cost. Got it? Okay. Let's go to our problems for today. Yeah. Okay. Okay, so we have 3 questions here. Okay. A transfer price based on variable cost will be set at blank per unit. Question 2, a transfer price based on full production cost would be set at blank price per unit. If Division A sells 100,000 fittings per month, the per unit transfer price is not likely to be below. Okay, so ayan yung mga questions for problem number 1. Sir Brad Pitt Corporation produces various products used in the construction industry. Division A produces 100,000 copper fittings each month. Relevant information for last month follows. Okay. Total sales, all external, meaning all external sales, okay, ibig sabihin, sales to outside customers, 250,000 pesos. If it's 100,000 units, 250,000, 250,000 divided by 100,000, that's 2.5 pesos per unit. Got it? Expenses, all on a unit base, okay, ibig sabihin, per unit. Variable manufacturing, 0.5, fixed manufacturing, 0.25, variable selling 0.3, fixed selling 0.4, variable general and admin 0.15, fixed general and admin 0.5. Total is 2.10. Okay? Per unit yan, per unit. Top level managers are trying to determine how a transfer price can be set on a transfer of 10,000 of the copper fittings from Division A to Division B. Okay, let's see. Question 1, a transfer price based on variable cost will be set at, actually dahilan to. So yung variable cost here, take note, both the product and period cost. Product plus period cost, okay? So variable, ano ba yung mga variable cost natin? Variable manufacturing, so 0.5, plus variable selling, 0.3, plus variable G&A, 0.15, this is equal to 0.95. Answer is letter C. Okay, letter C. Let's go to question number 2. A transfer price based on full production cost would be set at, when you say production cost, we know from the previous lessons, ibig sabihin yan, only the product cost or the inventoryable cost. Okay, both fixed and variable. Okay, so let's take a look at the given. Variable manufacturing, 0.5. Fixed manufacturing, 0.25. So, yun na siya. 0.5 plus 0.25. Answer is 0.75. Very easy. Letter A. Letter A. Let's go to question number 3. If Division A sells 100,000 fittings per month to outside customers, okay, the per unit transfer price is not likely to be below, okay. So, sir, what do you mean by that? Nagbebenta doon 100,000 fittings to outsiders. So, tama ba? Nagpo-produce daw ng 100,000 and sells 100,000 units to outside customers. This is an example of without excess capacity. Okay? Without excess capacity, ang mangyayari doon is, ano yung rule natin? If there's no excess capacity, okay? Variable cost plus the contribution margin. But we know, variable cost plus contribution margin is also your selling price, right? The selling price here is 2.5. Answer here is not likely to be below 2.5, letter D. Got it? Okay, if there's no excess capacity, it's usually at the selling price or market price. Okay, so easy pa yan. Siyempre, meron pa akong problem number two for you. Steel transfer pricing. Okay. Pricing. Speaking of pricing, alam nyo guys, yung pricing ng Pinnacle CPA review app, sobrang sulit niyan. Huh? We'll launch the Android version by March and iOS by April. Guys, standby kayo kasi pag ni-launch namin, meron kaming huge discounts for the first, let's say, 200 subscriptions. Okay? The Pinnacle app contains all CPA board subjects, questions, answers with complete solutions, explanations, summary per topic. You can also take mock exams and meron pang analytics per subject. Wala ka nang hahanapin dyan. Okay. Let's go to problem number two. Ayan, medyo mas challenging to compared to problem number one. Okay. Pag nag-gets yung problem number two, okay na kayo with transfer pricing.
Last, if you appreciate this free accounting tutorial, don't forget to subscribe and turn on the notification bell so you get notified whenever I have a new video.
Okay. You have four questions here. Okay? Four questions. But, tingin mo natin yung given. Okay, let's read. Division A of Pinnacle Company makes a part that can either be sold to outside customers or transferred internally to Division B for further processing. Annual data relating to this part are as follows. Annual production capacity, 80,000 units. Selling price of the item to outside customers, 35. Variable cost per unit, 23. Fixed cost per unit, 5. Okay, we know selling price minus variable cost, tama ba? 35 minus 23. This is your contribution margin, right? It's equal to 12. Okay, the CM is equal to 12. As you notice, yung contribution margin is very important in MAS. Okay. Division B of Pinnacle Company requires 15,000 units per year and is currently paying an outside supplier 33 per unit. Consider each part below independently. Okay? Just a recap. So, yung production A is 80,000 units per year. Si B, kailangan niya ng 15,000 units. Okay? So, si B, pwede siyang bumili from A or from outside. Tama? And we know, hindi siya pwedeng lumagpas ng selling price. Got it? Okay. If outside customers demand only 50,000 units per year, what is the lowest acceptable transfer price from the viewpoint of the selling division? Okay, so let's analyze. So if annual capacity is 80,000, ang binibenta lang niya currently outside is 30,000, tama ba? It means, 50,000, it means meron pang 30,000 si A na available to Division B. Tama ba? So it means there is an excess capacity. Okay? The incremental cost in that case, if there's an excess capacity, is equal to the variable cost, which is 23. Answer here is 23, which is letter B. Got it? Okay. Kasi may excess capacity. Wala ka namang walang opportunity cost or lost sales in this case, right? Because magbebenta ka ng 50, meron ka pang 30 na excess capacity, pwede mo pang bigyan si B ng 15,000 units. Got it? Okay. So, simple lang siya actually. For transfer pricing, hindi natin kailangan usually ng calculator here. Kailangan lang i-analyze ano yung situation. And you should know kung ano yung general rule in transfer pricing. Okay? If outside customers demand 80,000 units, what is the lowest acceptable transfer price from the viewpoint of the selling division? If yung production is 80, outside sales 80, it means pag nagbenta siya kay B, meron siyang opportunity cost or lost contribution margin, right? So ano yung magiging acceptable transfer price? Incremental cost, which is 23, plus opportunity cost or lost contribution margin, which is 12. Right? 23 plus 12 is equal to 35. 35 is actually also your selling price. Answer here is letter A. Okay? Still following me? Okay. Actually, simple lang siya, di ba? Basta alam yung general rule natin. Alright. So, let's go to question 3. Okay, question 3. If outside customers demand 80,000 units, okay, 80,000 units, hindi yung capacity niya, and if by selling to Division B, Division A could avoid 4 per unit in variable selling expense. What is the lowest acceptable transfer price? Okay, parang question 2 lang siya. The difference is that hindi na daw mag-i-incur ng 4 per unit na variable selling expense. Okay? So, answer again, balik lang tayo sa concept. Incremental cost, which is the variable cost, the 23, right? 23. Pero actually, part of the 23, hindi mo i-incur, which is 4. Tama? 23 minus 4, yun yung incremental cost natin. And because there's no excess capacity, kailangan i-consider din natin yung opportunity cost, which is the contribution margin of 12, 23 minus 4 plus 12, this is equal to 31. Okay, final answer is 31, letter C. Got it? Okay. For question 4, and pag naintindihan nyo yung question 4, it means master nyo na yung transfer pricing. Okay? So, make sure na maintindihan nyo yung question 4. If outside customers demand 70,000 units, alright? So, just to recap, annual capacity ni A is 80. Okay? Outside customers, 70. And then, what is the lowest acceptable transfer price from the viewpoint of the selling division for each of the 15,000 units needed by B? Tama ba ang mangyayari dito? Capacity is 80,000. Si outside customers kailangan ng 70. Si B needs 15,000. So, 70 plus 15, 85. Sobra yun sa capacity ni division A. So, paano gagawin natin dyan? Tama ba? If 80,000 si yung capacity, yung 70,000 minus 70,000, right? May 10,000 pa. Yung 10,000 na yan, yun yung excess capacity. And yung kailangan ni B is 15, it means for the 15,000, yun yung without excess capacity. So, paano gagawin natin dyan? Tama ba, for the 10,000, we can price this at variable cost, while for the 5,000, ipaprice natin siya at variable cost plus contribution margin or selling price. Tama? So, ganito gagawin ko dyan. Mag-ratio lang ako dyan. So, for the 10,000, ang total niyan obviously is 15,000. So, gagawin ko dyan is 10 over 15. Okay, kasi kailangan one price lang. Eh, tama? 10 over 15 times the variable cost of 23. Okay? 23 plus 5 over 15. Okay? Ano ba yung variable cost plus CM natin? That's 35. Okay. It's also equal to the selling price times 35. Nag-get nyo ba? So, ginamit ko lang yung weight. Nag-weights lang ako according to alin yung may excess capacity, the 10,000 and 5,000. Ulitin ko, just to make sure na na-follow nyo siya. Yung 10 na to, ito yung excess capacity. Okay? So, pwede natin siya i-price at variable cost, which is the 23. Yung 5, wala nang excess capacity because up to 80,000 lang. 70 plus 10, 80 na yun. Kailangan 15, kulang ka pa ng 5. Yung 5, ipaprice mo siya at variable cost plus CM or the selling price, which is equal to 35. That's why plus 5 over 15 times 35. Okay, let's compute. Actually, yun lang yung kinalculator natin, right? So, ayan. 10 over 15 times 23, M plus 5 over 15 times 35 M plus, recall, 26.99, or it's equal to 27. 27. Letter B. Class is the end of this free tutorial. In Pinakel, we offer both in-house and online review. Regardless of your accounting background, we will provide you with the most efficient and effective review by focusing on the best review strategies, key points to remember, shortcuts, common tricks, and mistakes. For reservation and to know more about us, visit our website and Facebook page. All the links are in the description below. Reserve now because we only accept limited number of students in order to preserve the quality of our review. Class is missed. See you next meeting.